So now you're racing back in the United States. You've been back for how many years? Since 06?
Since 2008. I came back, I rode for Sony Duval in 2006, and then in 2007 rode for T-Mobile, which was a really cool team. It was the biggest team in the world. And right. Actually, a teammate of mine moved over from Sony Duval with myself, separate, but together we talked about it. And I got to ride with him again in 2007 in the Tour of Italy. That's and good. He's Italian, and he won the Maglia Rosa leader's jersey for 6 days. He led his own, you know, race in his own country, so that was pretty cool to be a part of.
Yeah. Oh, you had some fun experiences.
Yeah, it was
amazing experiences.
It's definitely, yes. Yeah. Then in 2008, I came back to America because I wanted to try to see. I was kind of tired of all the doping scandals, and it was really hard for me. There was big ones that blew up while I was over there.
Right.
In fact, in 2007, big one that happened while we were at the Tour of Italy. So it was kind of frustrating being around that all the time. And being a clean cyclist and practicing in my whole life, you just get tired of being labeled as just because you're a cyclist that you are taking drugs when in fact you're not. And you can do well. It's hard to do really well. It was hard for me to do really well, but I was able to get some results.
Right.
And do my job all the time. So.
That's got to be frustrating.
Yeah.
With that over there.
But,
so then you came back to the States, and it's not so much on that level here.
No, and I mean, it's great racing. It's totally different. The conditions, the weather, the road surface, the depth of riders in Europe is you have 200 guys that show up to a race, and, you know, they're all really amazing. Here in America, you have 150 guys show up to a race, and 50 of them are, you know, the depth is still really good, and there's more Europeans and more Aussies and different countries coming to America making the races.
So, you know. So the U.S. racing scene is getting a little bit more international than it was maybe like 10 years ago?
Definitely, yeah. And then it's fun for me to do some pro mountain bike races, mix it up some there. That's something I've always wanted to do. I had some fun doing that last year. And just, you know, fill in some of the weekends that aren't great road races.
Right.
Mix it up
a little bit. Have some more fun with
definitely.
It.
Definitely.
Why not? So you're living in Santa Barbara now, full time for the most part.
Yeah.
Training here. Tell us about what else can we talk about? How much training do you do in the wintertime versus race season?
Probably most of my training is done in the winter, even though it's the off season. I mean, the biggest volume I do 25, 30-hour weeks. Probably 30-hour week on the bike is the biggest week I do. And then this winter started trying to do a lot more cross training, and that's when my girlfriend and I contacted Peter Park to try to really improve and really focus on some things outside of cycling that would really benefit us in cycling. So
you crossed Peter Park. Tell us about Peter Park. He's kind of gotten somewhat popular, and you know, he's been known in Santa Barbara for kind of the uber endurance trainer, but how did you hear about Peter, and how did you decide to contact him?
Well, it was actually my girlfriend who sent the email to Peter, and he was super gracious. I think same day we got an email back saying, sure, come on in, and let's work something out. He really wanted to work with professional athletes, and we had heard he had an awesome reputation, and we really wanted to try to do something different. He's not just going to the gym and just kind of wasting our time doing basic things. So, and it was huge. Super, super, super gracious person. Super, yeah. I mean, his title speaks for itself. He has famous athletes and top-notch studs to work with.
Reputation precedes him.
For a reason, yeah. And just, but super cool, down-to-earth person that's, yeah, I feel like I owe a lot to just from what he's given to me, so.
So he introduced you, he and Eric Goodman introduced you to foundation training. Was that kind of a real different approach to what you've done, or what do you think?
Yeah, definitely. I mean, the foundation was an awesome way to start off all of our workouts, and something was totally new to me. It was huge for my flexibility, and I really think that it helped me stay injury-free during this circuit training that we were doing because it's so intense. So, I mean, it really helped my flexibility, stability, core strength.
And then transferring that to the bike, you felt a pretty significant difference from say last year maybe? Or?
Huge difference. I worked out for 4 months this winter, two times a week for an hour and a half, both times. Well, I worked out with you, so you know how hard it was.
Yeah.
And the classes were great. I mean, it's just no shortage of a challenge, but all of the things were structured in a way that was super beneficial, and the foundation really was... Really, it was key to staying injury-free, and also it's, you know, challenging enough in itself. You could do a whole hour and a half on that and make it as challenging as you want. But I also found it a great way to get warmed up for and stretch for the actual stuff we were doing in the gym.
Sure, sure. Heavier weights and circuits.
Yeah.
Well, great. So, racing now, what do you see yourself doing 5 years from now? 10 years from now?
I want to open a coffee shop. It's something I'm actually working on right now. Coffee roasting and coffee shop. It's something Kim and I have been working on the last couple years. We went to a business school about it, and something I have a passion for, and we've both talked about for quite a while. So That's something that I'd really like to do. I still like to stay in the sport some. It doesn't have to be necessarily in cycling, but just I love being fit. I like being healthy. I've already started coaching some people. Just that's always fun to give back and help see people improve that have the passion and were, you know, are younger, just like I was one time. So that's definitely
a huge
fun
advantage
to see.
For any junior rider to get some.
Sure, and it was hard for me, and it was when people helped me out when I was younger. It really, it really went a long way. So
two other questions I was going to ask. One, when you were coming up, who were your mentors in the sport?
My family and then friends of the family that were just really supportive and wanted to see me succeed and not go the typical way, not feel like I had to go to college and just get a job. There was a lot of people, including my family, that was open and supportive in me going after my dreams and my goals. So that was huge because I had other friends that were talented as well that when they were done with high school, their family made them feel like there was only one thing you had to do, and that was go to school next, university. And so I had that huge support. The rider I looked up to most when I was growing up was Miguel Indurain, just because he was a big, tall guy like myself, and I really liked him because he was classy, quiet, just rode his bike well, and was really well-respected, so I thought that was pretty cool.
Sure, yeah. What about now? Do you have a favorite rider now in the pro ranks? Aside from yourself.
Yeah. the ones I respect the most are ones that I was teammates with, that I became good friends with, that I always like to see their name and results. From Mark Cavendish, was teammates with him, or different people. I don't know actually if I have a favorite right now. I can't really think of a favorite, but I always love seeing old teammates do really well and send them an email.
You guys have a personal relationship with and kind of root them on from
afar. Definitely.
Exciting.